Welcome to our exciting demo booth at Bonanza that we have set up. For folks who haven't met before, Charles Lamanna, Corporate Vice President on the engineering and product side. So my group builds Dynamics 365, Power Platform, and a few of the Copilot things you're going to see today. And if we kind of go through this session, we're hoping that kind of this between the intro and the demos, it'll really paint a good picture of how Copilot manifests at work and how people are actually using it today. And before we go too much to what's new, take a second, kind of look back in time. I like to kind of put it all into perspective. Microsoft Copilot is just shy of a year old. Back in last March is when we talked about the future of work and all the things that Copilot represents around that. And it's been a pretty action-packed 12 months since then. And we've been very consistently blown away with how users are taking advantage of Copilot to go get questions answered or go look up information. And it ranges from like the simple and personal and mundane to sophisticated, complex, and really important. You know, things like looking up recipes, how to make cookies, or things that are pretty serious, like how do I write an email to my boss to ask for a raise, like those types of things. And there's been over a billion conversations with Copilot since the initial launch, really kind of making a difference for those users. And what we've seen when we've gone out and interviewed people who use Copilot, 68% say that Copilot helps them jumpstart their creative activities and creative actions. So really kind of brainstorming and exploring new ideas. And 70% report that it makes them more productive. They're able to use Copilot to get tasks done and jobs done faster. And that's kind of what we wanted to do with Copilot. Make people feel more human, explore new ideas, be more creative, and also get jobs done faster and easier. But work is never done. And kind of what we see is the demands that we all see at work grow by the month and by the year. And some stats that are kind of mind-blowing to me is that a typical office user gets 250 emails a day, 150 Teams chats a day, and has to switch between apps 18 different times per day to find the information they want. And this really gets worse as we all communicate more and do more work and have more data sources and more systems. So the demands that we all face at work just grow and grow and grow and kind of sap, you know, time and energy alike. So that really is what we started to address with Copilot for Microsoft 365. We had our early access program, and then we had general availability last November, focused on making it so people are able to access all of their Office and Microsoft 365 data and have Copilot reason over it in the flow of work, in the Office apps they already use each and every day. And in a little bit, you'll see a live demo showing some of this, so you don't have to try to decipher the rapid kind of trailer that we have here. But you can see how Copilot shows up, say, inside of Teams as part of a recap and makes it easy to go ask questions about a meeting that you missed, or makes it easy to go to a chat-based experience and explore information or meetings or emails that you missed. So really, where people spend their time and data they already know and are used to, Copilot makes it easier and faster to get caught up and get the job done. And it's not just something that we put on like a slide. It's something that we also hear from users. So we've done similar surveys, and we've seen that users have told us that 73% of them complete tasks faster when they use Copilot for M365. And on top of that, 75% said that Copilot helps them find information that they want faster and easier. This goes back to that 18 times a day people are switching between applications. So really a rapid way to go find all the information that they want, get the job done. But we also heard another thing from users. And what they told us pretty consistently was that it's not one size fits all when it comes to Copilot. It's not like everybody in an organization, from front office to back office to engineering to product, can just use the same Copilot. They expect to have a Copilot tailored to their challenges each and every day. And if we look at kind of how that starts to show up, and as we get into some of the new things that we're going to talk about today, we really have this ambition of creating a Copilot for everyone. And like at Microsoft, we always talk about this idea of the information worker or the knowledge worker or the office worker. Like that's who uses Windows and Office in the past. But that's not a job. Like no one applies to be an information worker. People apply to be a salesperson, a finance professional, an accountant, a security researcher, a customer service rep. That's what goes in their LinkedIn profile and on their business card. And what we hear from those users is they want Copilot to understand what their job is every single day. So that's really what we're going to be talking about. And if we look at how this kind of manifests for them, is what they would say, like very concretely, is I want to draft an email with Copilot, and I want that email to also draw from my CRM. Or I want to prepare for a meeting with a customer, or while I'm in a meeting with a customer, and I want that to draw from my case management system or my contact center system. I don't want it just to draw from data sources inside of Office, which are valuable but incomplete to give a complete view of the enterprise or the business. So what we've done to go enable that is we took Copilot from Microsoft 365, and then we started to layer on top of it extensions and capabilities for specific business functions. And this idea is these role-based extensions can tailor that one Microsoft Copilot for a salesperson, for a customer service rep, for a finance professional, and more. And that's where and how Copilot for Sales, Copilot for Service, and Copilot for Finance came about. They are our role-based extension for Copilot for Microsoft 365. And when you use them, Copilot for Sales, Service, and Finance, they get all the benefit of those role-specific extensions and the core functionality of Copilot for Microsoft 365. And if we look at kind of how this shows up, customers and users want Copilot to not only help them be more productive, like do less monotonous, tedious tasks, but also to make the business more effective, to have better outcomes, better revenue, lower cost structure, those types of things. And another important thing that we heard from our customers is that no two companies are alike. The way this group does quarter close versus this company, slightly different, or the way this company does sales, slightly different than this one. So they need a way to go extend and tailor Copilot to match their business process. And that's where Copilot Studio comes in. Copilot Studio provides an easy, low-code way to tailor Copilot to a specific company or organization. And you'll see one of the great demos really showing that in action. So that's kind of the how that all layers up. Now, if we think about what that ultimately translates to, customers want access to all of their business data in the apps they use every day. So, and this is, I think, a really important kind of ecosystem connected view where people work in Outlook and Teams and PowerPoint and so on, but they want to draw from Dynamics or Salesforce or SAP or Oracle or what have you. So really that commitment to be in the apps you use every day with the data you need every day in one single integrated experience, core to Copilot. And I think it'll be interesting as you see the demos kind of how much the interoperability shows up. Now, if we go a little bit deeper into Copilot for Sales, if we look at the life of a sales rep, none of them wake up in the morning and say, you know what I want to do today? I want to update my CRM for my boss, and I want to take notes on emails and take notes on meetings and go track and move my opportunities between their different pipeline stages. They don't want to do that. They want to spend the time talking to customers, to their customers. They want to spend their time closing deals, building relationships, generating more revenue. And if you think about what gives them energy in the day, it's that talking to customers. So for what Copilot for Sales really is focused on is making it so the salespeople can focus on selling, not on administrative tasks, not on clerical tasks. So Copilot for Sales shows up in all those same Office applications as Copilot for M365, but brings the CRM data, whether it's Dynamics or Salesforce, and it brings the core prompts and core workflows and core experiences that a seller needs to get their job done faster. And if we kind of look at how that manifests, it very subtly and seamlessly integrates into Copilot for Microsoft 365. Like if it's an email summary or email generation, it just lines up transparently and pulls all the relevant CRM information. And this is also another one of the demos that you'll see in a bit, kind of full end-to-end running through a sales cycle using Copilot to do it more efficiently. And just one of the big items throughout this experience is that I'm able to operate on my CRM data. I can read it and I can write it without having to go to my CRM. So I don't have to switch apps. Copilot does the work for me to go from Outlook or Teams out to the CRM, just it's the single cockpit between Copilot and Office to get the job done. And what that means, based on the measurements we've done so far, is about 90 minutes back every week for a seller. And this is probably some of the worst 90 minutes they spend every week, too. And on top of that, that translates to a lot more time in front of the customer, with 67% of users reporting that they're now able to spend more time talking to customers, finding new leads and new opportunities, or building and expanding relationships. And that's kind of that double benefit of make users more productive and ultimately go drive a more effective and bigger impact for the business itself. So kind of both those things are really important. Now, it's not just salespeople, of course, it's also customer service reps. The same thing, like no customer service rep wants to have to spend all their time searching through different systems to find the answer to a customer question. No service rep wants to have to tell a customer, I don't know the answer to that question, like let me go transfer you. They want to be able to answer it really quickly, even if they've been on the job for only a couple of months. And really the idea, everybody's united by this desire to have an outcome and a solution as fast as possible. And what Copilot for Service does is it follows the service rep between all the applications they use and makes it easy for them to resolve problems and look up information without having to switch between different systems. And it's one AI Copilot, which is their companion, in Outlook, in Teams, in Excel, and even in the demo you'll see later, inside Salesforce itself. So you really have the opportunity for a Copilot that floats around across all these different surfaces. And how that translates is I'm able to get information about case history or customer information inside of Outlook, kind of like you can see right here. I can generate emails which draw from past communication, but also the information inside my case management system or inside my customer management system that I have, like a CRM or a CDP. So a real ability to go pull all that information together and be more informed and more capable and make it so I never feel as a service rep as though I don't have the answer to a question from a customer. Kind of what the benefit is on the other side of it is we've seen a 14% increase in the number of cases that can be worked for a single agent just because of Copilot. And this is something we experiment with, you know, A/B testing, control groups, not control groups. So the same customer service department can work a lot more cases as a result of using Copilot. Along those same lines, 12% increase in customer satisfaction. So the service rep, the customers they support, 12% happier on average. So productivity and customer experience. It's rare where a single piece of technology in less than a year could be rolled out and adopted and improve both those metrics, because that means more efficiency and happier customers, which usually means better retention, less churn, that type of thing. And kind of the last of the three Copilot extensions is the one to enable for finance professionals. And this is the news of the day, so this is the big demo that you'll see later on. And if we go look and you go talk to a typical financial analyst or someone who works in a finance org, they'll tell you that they feel like their main job is corralling mountains of Excel files. I mean, they just get file after file. They have to reconcile and map data together, clean up the information, do data prep. And sometimes it's not in Excel, sometimes it's in other systems. And this is what consumes their time. Instead of doing analysis, instead of being strategic, instead of driving the business forward, they feel like they're almost doing like data integration and data mapping. No one gets into finance or studies finance to do that type of job, you know, to corral the Excel sheets. So what Copilot for Finance does is it does that for you. It's able to take lots of different data sources using the power of Copilot to do mapping and matching and merging, to do things like three-way reconciliation and data prep, so you can spend all your time making the important decisions as opposed to editing data and doing data prep. And the thing about Copilot for Finance is already a typical finance professional spends most of their time in Excel. Like if you go and ask what's the most commonly used app for a finance pro, it's going to be Excel. So Copilot for Finance, front and center, inside of Excel with tailored experiences and workflows to help users with some of the most daunting and challenging problems that they face as part of their job, but solved with an AI angle. And this ranges from data prep, data analysis, all the way to communication with procurement and suppliers and customers for things like payment, all integrated inside of Office. And just like I talked about earlier for Copilot for Sales, this entire experience lives in Office 365. Users don't go out to an ERP or a custom app. They get to stay in the apps they know and love. And the data comes to them, and the intelligence comes to them, and the insights come to them. And if we look at just one of the processes available in Copilot for Finance, which is a variance analysis as part of a quarter close or month close, we see a 30% productivity benefit there. And that's because that tedium is taken out of it, and so people can spend more time doing the analytics and insights, less time doing the data prep. And kind of underneath all of this, we go back to that need for every customer to tailor and tweak just as they need it. Because we ship 80% of the value out of the box, but there's always a 20% which varies from company to company. And Copilot Studio is a straightforward, low-code way to go configure Copilot to exactly the needs that the customer has. You can do things like register plugins, which can draw from lots of different pre-built connectors that we have or APIs that you want to register. We're able to use generative AI to dynamically fill parameters and chain together actions and answers to solve problems in a very rapid fashion. And all of this can be published directly into Microsoft Copilot. So you can seamlessly integrate and extend the broader Copilot family. And one of the big things that we've heard from customers is key to all of this is the connector. So we have over 1,200 pre-built plugins and connectors in Copilot Studio. SAP, Oracle, ServiceNow, Workday, Adobe, Zendesk, and many, many more on-prem and in the cloud, you can seamlessly connect to from inside of Copilot. And if we don't have a connector for it, there's a way to extend it. And this has really helped unlock Copilot to the next level of productivity, because it's not just about having a large language model or a large language model plus the web. I also wanted to have access to my private data as an enterprise securely and safely. And Copilot Studio makes it really easy and straightforward to go do that. Now, how this is translated in practice is lots of customers have been able to quickly get value because they don't have to migrate their CRM or their ERP or change their data platform. And we already have over 100,000 organizations using Copilot across Dynamics 365 and Power Platform in our broader business applications portfolio. Companies like Visa, Schneider Electric, Northern Trust, Dentsu, and more. Inside of Microsoft, we, of course, use Copilot extensively with pretty significant benefits for our customer support organization and sales organization already. And this is something that's happening really, really quickly because the connectors make it possible to use Copilot without migrating your systems on the back end. And we see it's not just the executives and the leaders who get excited about the benefit of Copilot, it's also the end users. 77% of early Copilot users don't want to give it up. They like to use, it's become a part of their habits and something they use each and every day. And all of this that we've kind of talked about will have ultimately rolled out in less than a year. So we go all the way back to last March to tomorrow. In less than 1 year, we have Copilot, Copilot for Microsoft 365, Copilot for Sales, Copilot for Service, Copilot for Finance, Copilot Studio, an incredible amount of innovation and value, but still less than 1 year. So still early days for all of this. Like if you go back and think about that first year of the internet or smartphones, a lot happened, but it's still a lot is yet to happen. And that's the big thing we would say is, since all of this is just cloud delivered and SaaS, it's continuously being updated and improved. So even what's possible today will be more impressive a week from now, a month from now, a quarter from now, and a year from now. So that's all I have for remarks. So just huge thank you for listening in. And we have a bunch of great demos which will show live running code of all of this in action.